Now, you might be watching this after Thursday, but this came out on Halloween, so I'm wearing the costume. Go! 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 Hello, and welcome back, everybody, to the video series dedicated show on MTV that you were watching when you were a little baby. That's right, I'm talking about The Challenge, Season 34, War of the Worlds 2, Episode 10! 10, everybody! And in this episode, CT shows off their dead bod. Nani gets paranoid on a girl's elimination day? Wow, who would have thought that? And Leroy flays up his team, Michael Scott style. Boom, you're roasted. But let's start off where last episode left off, and that was in the middle of this Jordan and Turbo bout yet again. Now, we saw a majority of what happened in that fight and what started it in the last episode. This is the tail end of it, as security was holding Turbo back, putting him in the room. Turbo was walking around, pacing around like a tiger, like a lion in a cage. And finally, he gets dressed and he goes into the back of a car and drives off, where me and everybody in the house and a lot of people on Twitter, as I was live tweeting this, thought that maybe he was just going to the hotel to kind of cool down for the night and he'll be back later the next day to compete in the daily challenge or just be in the house after the daily challenge. However, that was not the case this time, as TJ at the Daily Challenge told everybody that that was Turbo's second warning. That was one warning over the limit, and so he was DQ'd from the game. He will not return this season. Over the seasons, people have done way more and stayed on the TV show. And to say that what we saw was warranted enough to get Turbo kicked out, to me, is kind of weak sauce. I think that's a weak excuse. I know we didn't see the full thing. It was edited for TV. We didn't get to see every single minute of what happened. So something could have happened that they didn't show. But to me, I think it was weak sauce. I hate to see him go this way. But we must go on with who we have right now. I know Jordan is super happy right now, but come on, man. That was just kind of garbage. But let's just get into this week's daily challenge called Incoming! And in this daily challenge, there's gonna be balls in the middle of this mud pit. Both teams will start from the opposite side of this mud pit, run in, wrestle for a ball, get it across the line. If you get it across the line, you're safe and you're going on to the next round. This daily challenge will be played in 4 rounds. At the end of the 4th round, the one person to take the ball over the line wins it for their team. Now, with that being said, it'll be split up between a guy series and a girl series. Guys were going first, and let me tell you right now, I was laughing my butt off seeing that Jordan was the first one eliminated. But let's get into it as the rest of the rounds go on, and Leroy was actually killing it in this daily challenge, and it was him in the final round against Joss and Rogan. And I mean, once you're going 2v1 with one ball, it's nearly impossible to win, as Rogan did the strategic thing of tackling Leroy right at the beginning, and Joss picked up the ball and kind of just walked across the line, where the UK guys actually won their heat and their series. Now it's on to the UK girls, and the pressure is on them to win. And let me tell you right now, Kaylee is the MVP of this daily challenge. I mean, she was able to spy the ball that was away from everybody else, scoop it up, and score every time. She scored first, like, in every single round. It came down to the final round, where it was Kaylee and Dee for the UK girls, and for the US team, it was Cara Maria only. Cara Maria got to the ball first, got her vice grip on that ball, but the Kaylee and Dee were scratching at the ball, poking it out, punching it out, and finally, it loosened up. Cara fumbled the ball, and Dee held Cara down as Kaylee scooped it up and high-stepped it across the line like she was just Deion Sanders taking an interception 70 yards to the house. And that's when the UK wins this daily challenge. They are celebrating in slow motion in the mud. And the hard part came after the daily challenge win, as TJ asked who was going to be the speaker. And let me tell you right now, they look like they didn't even speak about who was going to be speaker, because I don't think they even thought they were going to win. So it comes down to a vote, and Kaylee was voted as speaker of the team, and she chose Jenny and Joss to be in the tribunal with her. Now, let's go into the U.S. nomination ceremony. They decided to start with Leroy since he's the leader of the U.S. team, and he started the conversation off by saying, I'm not going to say Nani's name, and I'm not going to say Ninja's name because she's on my new alliance, so now I'm going to say Tori's name. Just before the nomination ceremony, Josh, Zach, Jordan and Tori were all talking out on the porch, talking about how they're probably going to gun after Tori, and she wants to go up against Ninja. Now, I'm sure she was talking about the UK team, but if you know that you're going to go into an elimination by one or the other, whether it's your team or the UK team voting yourself in, you're not really that surprised, are you? I mean, I guess you could be, but they were overreacting. Even last episode, Jordan talked to Zach in the kitchen about him and Tori wanting to go into elimination so that they could switch teams and go to the UK team. This is all part of their plan. Cam was right in her confessional that this all could have just been avoided and they could have just been like, look, majority votes Tori in, let's all go inside the house and eat. Tori gets overzealous about selling herself switching to the UK team that she was swearing on her family and everybody that she knows and loves. They go in thinking that she wants Ashley and Ninja, even though she said she wanted the best, but she's leaving Kara's name out of it. I don't know. Before the UK group meeting about who they all want to see in the elimination against Tori, that's when Tori and Georgia were talking and how Tori was like, please, please, please get them to say that they will vote in Ashley into the elimination. And Georgia says, I'll do my best. But in the other room, Kara, Cam, Ninja, and Ashley were all talking about how they need to think of an idea of getting Georgia into the elimination with Tori. As if Tori switch teams, takes out a member of one of their alliances, which is one number down from them, Tori switches over to the UK team and then joins forces with Theo, Georgia, and Jenny to get the numbers on that side and start dwindling the numbers from over on the UK side. And that's when Kaylee's walking by the room and she's like, oh, you want Georgia in? I'll vote her in. Georgia, Kaylee doesn't need any reason to put in Georgia. She wants to put in Georgia. She wants to throw in Georgia. Skip to the UK meeting real quick. Everybody agrees. Throw in Ashley after 5 seconds of talking. Now go into the proving grounds where Tori is thinking that Ashley is going to be a thing. Everybody on the UK side is thinking that Ashley is going to be the vote in, to the point where Jenny is doing this long drawn out speech about how we all came together as a team. We're a team unit. We're doing teamwork, and us as a team and up as a team unit wants to vote in Ashley. And Kaylee goes, you thought, as I'm gonna put in Georgia, and everybody starts flipping out. Mainly Theo and Georgia, as Georgia and Theo are getting in Joss's face, going, come on, man, come on, man. Are you mad? Are you mad? Is this real? Are you pinching me? And Georgia starts to cry even before Joss can get the vote out of his mouth. He says he'll stick to the plan and vote in Georgia. And that's when Georgia gets thrown into the proving grounds yet again, her third time this season, and she is crying in the confessionals. I already know that she's not gonna do well in this proving ground, as she is already crying to the camera before getting set up. And TJ is pretty flabbergasted by seeing both Tori and Georgia in the proving grounds tonight for this elimination called Blockbuster. And Blockbuster is all about this wall that where you push the wall in, some of the rocks in, it comes out on the other side and you have to push it back in. There's three rounds that you're gonna be playing this in. The best of three wins this game, and the one with the most pushed in blocks after 90 seconds of each round wins, gets to stay in this game, and the other one gets kicked out of this game. Let me tell you right now, this one could be a fun elimination on paper. It could be a fun elimination to do. Personally, I thought this was pretty anticlimactic. I didn't think it was that tension heavy. I didn't think it had that much pressure on the whole situation. I was just like, okay, cool. This 90 seconds, we're not gonna see the full 90 seconds, and it's kind of boring, as both girls just stood with their backs against the wall for majority of the 90 seconds on the both rounds that they played. They played two rounds. Tori won 7-6. The first round and the second round was the same 7-6, as Georgia was finally kicked out of this game. She trash-talked Kaylee on her way out. Tori, being victorious as she is, standing next to TJ, and TJ gives her the option that we've been hearing for weeks and weeks and weeks, but nobody is taking the opportunity to do. And he goes, do you want to stay on the US team or do you want to switch teams? And that's when she's like, I'm going to switch to the UK team. And yay, she switches to the UK team. And the worst part of this whole switching teams was her and Jordan making the same corny joke almost 2 seconds apart, where they showed Jordan on top of the steps going, oh, we're gonna look for some real estate in the UK, and then switch to the confessional of Tori going, we're gonna look for some real estate in the UK, kind of thing. It was like, wow, that wasn't funny the first time I heard it, and it definitely isn't funny 2 seconds right after hearing the same thing. I think that was a bit of a myth on the edit there. But that's where this episode ends. We finally have our first turncoat. What did you think about this episode? Let me know that in the comments section below. What do you think about the decision of them DQing Turbo? Do you think it was meh? Or are you happy to see him go? Personally, I'm sad. I think he's a great competitor and I wish he was still in this game. But what do you think about it? Let me know that in the comments section below. What do you think about the daily challenge? Did you think that the UK just ripped it on the US? Let me know that in the comments section below. And what do you think about the US voting in Tori? And what do you think about the UK voting in Georgia? And what do you think about Georgia being sent home? Are you happy she's gone? Or are you gonna be sad that she's gone? And what do you think about Tori switching teams? Were you at all shocked, or were you like, yeah, we already knew that? Let me know that in the comment section below. I want to hear what you have to say. I want to hear everything and everything. Also, what's your favorite Halloween candy? I don't care if you're watching this Sunday or 3 Sundays from now. I want to hear what you have to say because this came out on Halloween. Let me know that in the comment section below. I want to hear what you have to say. Thank you so much for watching. While you're down there, hit that like and subscribe button. I'll be back really, really soon with a challenge brief history on Saturday, going in blind on Tuesday, and join me next week for the challenge season 34 War of the Worlds 2 review and recap. But until then, peace.